Are you tired of typing out long and complicated messages, with the results still being kind of average? Or do you have to read through long research papers or articles for work or university, but really a well-written summary would be good enough too? Well, fear not. Introducing ChatGPT, the AI-powered chatbot that solves these issues and so many more for you. In this video, I'll be showing it how to use it in everyday scenarios to superpower your work life, your studying, or just to make communicating with other human beings via text way easier. And best of all, it's still in beta and completely free, so there's really no reason not to try this out. You can use it as a personal writer that is available 24/7. It's as well educated as is the internet, and it can use various writing styles. But let me show you this in practice. So let's say you're at work and your boss gave you an extra task and you don't have the time to complete it without neglecting other tasks. Instead of tediously writing up by email and checking it multiple times so it's polite and well written, simply say, write me a business email to my boss that tells him that the new task that I receive requires me to give up other projects. And look at that, perfectly structured, polite, and to the point. But maybe we don't want an email, but a WhatsApp message. So let's say now write it in one sentence. This personal writer you can also use for essay, blog articles, or even reports if you feed it some of the information that you came up with. And best of all, it's really good at the English language, so there will be no mistakes in there. When it comes to grammar and vocab, always double check the info because sometimes it can mess up. Next up, we have my personal favorite use case. It can answer questions, but not just factual questions like Google could answer. You can give it personal questions related to relationships or mental health, and it will actually come in with a lot of good advice. As Christmas is coming up, let's look at an example where I ask ChatGPT what I should get my girlfriend for Christmas. What are some creative ideas for Christmas presents that my girlfriend would enjoy? This is too good. I mean, really, these ideas are more creative, unique, and interesting than most human advice on this question. Look, an experience gift, a subscription to a monthly box service, handmade piece of jewelry, support a cause she cares about, photo album or scrapbook. And you can always just go in and say, do you have five more? And look, it even has some advice. The keys to show her that you care and want to make her happy. In Google, you get a lot of articles with these lists. But let's be real, after accepting the cookies and skipping over the ads, most of these are just affiliate links for products they want to make money on. And none of them tell you the point of the whole exercise here. All right, next up we have the analogy maker. And as the name already implies, this allows you to create analogies for various situations in life. This will come in really handy in business, but also in personal communication. Now, let's assume that you met a new girl and you really like her and you want to answer something witty, but you can't think of anything. And maybe you're about to meet her and it's raining outside. So let's ask ChatGPT for help here. Here's a few ideas for analogies you could use to describe the rain outside. And while these are great if you're writing classic literature, let's just say, can you use more everyday language? And here you go, an extremely romantic approach to the whole thing. What if we told it less romantic? And wow, look at this analogy. Okay, you might not use this with the conversation, the girl, but you get the point. You can also just tell it, analogy maker, I'm really tired. And as it's contextual, if I want more, I'll just tell it, more analogies, please. And there you go. If you tell somebody I'm a candle that has burned down to the wick, I think they should get the message here. And the next everyday use case would be a TLDR. If there's a long article, ChatGPT can summarize it for you. So for example, let's go to Wikipedia and copy the entire part about the future of artificial intelligence. If I simply say TLDR, and then in quotation marks, I post the article. It gives me one paragraph with the key points in the entire text. So I could pull this up 2 minutes before a meeting starts, and I could educate myself on topics that otherwise would take maybe an hour.
Nice.
The amazing thing here is you can use it on research articles, or if you have PDFs, just copy out the text, paste it in here, and it will summarize the whole thing in one paragraph for you. Now, of course, this leaves out some of the information in here, but if you need to get a bird's eye view of the topic, this is the way to do it. Last but not least, it can take your notes and turn them into a summary. So for now, every time you're diving into a new topic or you met a new person, all it takes is taking a few notes, and this thing will spit out an entire summary that you can use as a social media post, or you can send it out via an email. Now, I'll just say notes to summary, and let's just say I had these four notes on the topic of artificial intelligence, which I picked up from some class I watched. Good God, this is so good. I'm still blown away by how good this is. But maybe we don't want this formal style. So here's a little tip. You can go ahead and say, write that in the style of a second grader. And it does it. Look at that formulation. Artificial intelligence is a smart technology that is growing and changing very quickly. This is so much more approachable. So if you're learning something from here on out, all you need to do is take note, and it can write essays just from the notes. Okay, so I think it's beyond clear that this tech is game changing, but it's also worth considering that this power could be used for evil purposes too. And that's exactly what this video is about.